going on, everybody? Quick little run, trying to avoid the mud today. Got another indoor comp here in a couple days, so I'm not trying to get these tires all muddy if I can help it. Today I'm just out here kind of testing out these new pin tires, and I've got the Injora green silicone inserts in the pin tires today. Haven't got to run these with the green inserts yet, so I'm gonna see if these do any better than the blue ones. These things are super soft, so we'll see if I got too much weight for them. Other than that, same old Gapra, doing the same old Gapra things. So we'll see how these new inserts do in the Injora pin tires. Probably not going to be a long one today. Just a quick test run. Alright, enough messing around with the little stuff. Before I get these tires too muddy, we'll see how they do on the wet, mossy concrete up here on Hardline. Mixed with a little bit of mud, it's starting to pick it up a little bit. this one's gonna happen. Got a nice coat of mud smeared all over that slimy concrete. Took a little bit more wheel speed than what I wanted. Still wasn't like a full bump of wheel speed, but not too bad though. That concrete is real slippery. And there's a pretty good coating of mud all over the bottom of it there. These pin tires really picked that mud up. Well, we've already come too far now. Those tires are absolutely caked. Might as well keep going. I really don't think anything I've got could pull this line today. At least not with this much mud on the tires.
there. So close. I think if I fought that for a little while, I might be able to get it from the far right, but now that my tires are absolutely caked with mud, let's go try something potentially a little harder. Thank you. Well, I'm pretty much concluded the same thing as I did the last time I had these out. It doesn't matter how good they do on straight rocks or concrete. Whatever you do, don't take these in any kind of mud whatsoever. Because whatever performance they've got beforehand disappears completely once they get caked in mud. So it's not exactly the fairest of test runs on this. These things are just not made for any kind of mud or wet dirt or anything of the sort. Now, I will say that in dry conditions, these things are awesome. And even though they don't have the bite right now because of the mud, these green inserts seem to be just about perfect for this particular setup. So, the only complaint I've got for the day is I didn't follow my plan and I got into the mud. That stuff is hard to avoid up here in the pit. Well, that was kind of a bust and kind of not. I don't really have any options this time of year. I'm gonna get into the mud. So, regardless, I'm happy with these things. The green inserts inside of the Injora pin tires, excellent combo. At least for this particular rig. I couldn't tell you exactly what it weighs. It's not the heaviest thing in the world, but it's also not the lightest thing in the world. So, I don't know, maybe one of these days I'll weigh the thing. Regardless, I'm gonna go get these tires cleaned up, and yeah, I don't know if I'll run them this weekend or not. Kind of like having a little bit more ground clearance with those ruptures. These are a little bit shorter and a little bit more narrow. We'll see what happens. Anyways, for those of you who stuck around to the end here, I'll give a little sneak peek at my wintertime project. I'll throw in a few pictures here and there. I still got a long way to go, but got a good start on the wrecker that I'm building for Axial Fest this year. So, anyways, hope you enjoy what progress I've got done so far on that. Base camp, straight axle builder's kit, FJ40 cab only, and then I'm building a bed and the boom and everything. I'm building all that myself out of different kinds of metal here and there. So take a gander at that. Let me know what you think. And yeah, see what happens next. Maybe this weekend I'll actually get a little footage from the comp. We'll see. Thanks for watching. Hope y'all have a good one. And we'll catch you in the next one. Later.